Before I moved to New York, I was living in Scranton, Pennsylvania, working at a parking garage. Spent most of my days inside a little booth trying to find all the different ways I could entertain myself. And there weren't very many. But one of the best ways I found was by talking to Bill, the garage maintenance man. Bill would pass by my booth while making his rounds about twice a day, cleaning things up, fixing broken equipment, and all the while sneaking shots of Johnny Walker and poorly covering up the aroma with shots of mouthwash. I liked the guy. But Bill started working there when he was a teenager back in the 70s. And by the time I came around, he had about 2,000 stories to tell all of us newcomers, each one to show us just what a badass he was. All of us at the garage kind of suspected these stories were more of tall tale than of actual facts. One was about how he had done a stretch of time in prison in the 80s for some armed robbery of a local corner store. My suspicion was he actually just spent a few nights in a Scranton jail cell for some petty crime and with no one to post up the bail. He'd also claimed to have played a role in a drug smuggling ring, with ties to Pablo Escobar and other Colombian drug traffickers. More than likely, Bill was just selling shitty weed out of his mom's basement. He told us about fights he'd been in, crazy women he'd been with, and about the 9mm he used to keep in the inside pocket of his stonewashed jean jacket, which I'm sure was actually just a Swiss Army knife he'd kept from his Boy Scout days. I suppose in his own way, Bill was some kind of badass, at least in his tall tales he was. But in real life, I think Bill was just looking to fit in, but he never quite could.
He was rolling down the road of sin. Was he running? Could you look again? He wasn't much thinking about now or then, those days. He said his name was Crazy Bill. They told us stories and we all knew them well. He'd been locked up in the county jail for 8 days. And I thought that I might come around, might even try to settle down. But something been lost and ain't ever been found in me. Heard him talk about the golden days, when all the women he loved were always twice his age. And even got his name up on the old front page, and we all read it. We heard about the night he almost died, down on the corner back in 85. There wasn't much thinking about being alive, so he took his chances on. And he ran out saying, I thought that I might come around, might even try to settle down. But something been lost and ain't ever been found in me. From a different time, in those days you'd find a way to make a dime, run a cocaine cross the borderline, but we all knew he didn't. The one night Billy got up in a fight, he said, man, I'll kill you, and he flashed his knife. All that fella just laughed and knocked out Bill's lights, with the whole town watching. We all heard him saying, I thought that I might come around, I might even try to settle down. But something been lost and ain't ever been found in me. So before I go out on my way, please tell me there'll be better days. Oh, that's all right, Billy, you got a hill to raise. So go on and do it. Go on, go on.